really strong Worlds finish, and for such a player as accomplished as he is in, like, nationally in various nationals over in Europe, he really wants that kind of big Worlds finish.
Yeah, and both players are 4-0. We actually got to take a look at Marcus's game record. He is only 8-1.
Yeah, he's only dropped one single game.
And going into team preview, of course, Eduardo going to be running the Xerneas, Kangaskhan, Groudon, Bronzong, Hitmontop, and Thunderous. Like I said, the big six with a little bit of differentiation. And Mark is going to be running an interesting team of Gengar, Rayquaza, Raichu, Bronzong, Hitmontop, and Kyogre. Sort of a Rayquaza-Kyogre team that we've been seeing a lot of.
It's a team we've seen a lot as a kind of a counter to these Groudon Xerneas teams, because you have the Rayquaza and the Kyogre for that Groudon, and then you've got the Gengar, the Bronzong, in order to counter the Xerneas. So it's a team that's pretty much designed to beat these big six type teams. What's interesting is both players have Hitmontop. Not something that's too common.
Hitmontop is a good Pokemon, very supportive Pokemon, with all of the moves that it has and the great Intimidate ability that we see right now. Hitmontop and Gengar leads out for Marcus versus Groudon and Bronzong out for Eduardo's side. And we do see Groudon go ahead and revert back to its primal form. You know, a very standard lead out from Eduardo's side. Of course, the Bronzong Groudon, very popular duo. Hitmontop and Gengar, not so much as popular.
No, Hitmontop has not been a popular Pokemon at all. It used to be very popular last time we had a format like this in 2010. We saw Hitmontop very frequently, but this year, Hitmontop just kind of outclassed. Usually it's Salamence, Mega Salamence that we see bringing the Intimidate. Hitmontop can't really deal a whole lot of damage in this format anymore, because Pokemon have just become too powerful, too bulky. But we see it here. It can get Wide Guard, which is certainly good against a lot of common Pokemon. Feign is a really interesting option that it can have. Of course, the Fake Out, which you always expect to see from Hitmontops.
And we do see Eduardo now go ahead and switch out that Bronzong. Not going to want to stay in. Gengar can hit it with a very powerful Shadow Ball. Switching in that Kangaskhan instead, maybe trying to take that Shadow Ball. Gengar, of course, is a Pokemon that, you know, kind of has issues. Does it carry Sludge Bomb, Shadow Ball, a lot of moves that it wants? As we do see Gengar Mega Evolve as Hitmontop goes for the Fake Out, the Shadow Attack ability on Gengar is going to be huge to trap both Kangaskhan and Groudon right now. As we do see a Taunt come out onto the Bronzong slot, which is now the Kangaskhan, as Groudon does flinch and cannot move.
Really interesting to bring the Kangaskhan in here, because you don't want to. Kangaskhan just does not have a good matchup against Hitmontop and Gengar, and especially Mega Gengar, because now you can't even switch out. So Kangaskhan's position, not great. Groudon, though, does have a very good position, being able to hit Gengar now since it Mega Evolved, so a Ground-type move will be able to hit it. The Intimidate may be able to help Gengar take a Precipice Blades, depending on how it's trained. So certainly an option for Marcus if he decides to have Gengar go for an attack, or maybe a Will-O-Wisp on Kangaskhan if he is carrying that. But Eduardo, he's got to love the Groudon here. He's not going to like it if Hitmontop comes out for like a Kyogre or a Rayquaza, though.
And we do see Kyogre come in right now, going to go ahead and change the weather. That's one great thing about that Shadow Tag ability. It's just easy for you to maintain your weather when your opponent cannot switch out at all.
Yeah.
Kyogre does revert back to
his primal
form.
I expect to see a Protect here, too, from Mega Gengar, since he's bringing in this Kyogre, too. He doesn't want to let Mega Gengar go down before he can lock in and KO this Groudon.
And we do see Kangaskhan now follow suit. Gonna go ahead and Mega Evolve right now. Both Megas are out on the field for both players, as Kangaskhan does get threatened by a possible Will-O-Wisp from this Gengar. We'll have to see what happens. Gengar does protect itself. You're right, Ray. Good call. Not gonna want to get that lock broken immediately, as Kangaskhan goes for a huge double edge. It is not intimidated. Gonna hit that Kyogre. Gonna do a good amount of damage, doing about 60% to that Kyogre, as Kangaskhan does take some recoil. And Groudon does go for a Fire Punch, but it does fizzle out in that heavy rain, so a good switch right there. Unfortunate that he did have to take that double edge.
Yeah, I know he was expecting the Wide Guard there, that's why he was going for the Fire Punch, but at the same time, you kind of had to expect Kyogre to come in there, at least as a possibility. I don't know if that was the right play, but at least he got some damage on Kyogre, and Kangaskhan will be faster, so it should be able to pick up the KO here. But again, Hitmontop could always come in and just knock out the Kangaskhan, provide more Intimidate support. But again, Groudon in a good spot against Gengar, just not against Kyogre. Depending on speeds, it's not all bad for Eduardo. He can certainly turn this battle into his favor. It's probably still neutral, I'd say. Of course, it does always depend on how Pokemon are trained. Maybe if Gengar switches out for Hitmontop, can that allow Kyogre to take a double edge? I don't know, but Marcus certainly will know.
And Groudon does go for Protect here as Gengar goes for a Will-O-Wisp onto this Kangaskhan. Gonna get that burn, slowly chip away at Kangaskhan and reduce its physical damage by half. As Kangaskhan now does go for a double edge, gonna connect onto that Kyogre. Is it gonna be enough to pick up the KO? It is enough to pick up the KO with a critical hit.
Oh, that critical hit.
On that second one, it was gonna be close. It might have mattered. It might not have, as the heavy rain does lift.
Yeah, it looked really close, so it's hard to say, but it looked like that definitely could have mattered.
I think it's something that Marcus might have thought about in his pregame planning, as Kangaskhan's taunt does wear off, but the lock is still there, so right now Marcus has to figure out what the best option is to send in.
Yeah, I think it has to be Hitmontop. Of course, we don't know what his fourth Pokemon is yet, but Hitmontop, very good against Kangaskhan. The Intimidate will get Groudon to two stages of lowered attack, which will certainly help his Gengar in, you know, lasting longer. And there's no way for Eduardo to switch out either. So I think a Hitmontop switch is good. But again, we don't know what Marcus's last Pokemon is. Maybe it's even better than Hitmontop. But he's thinking really hard about this situation. So
it could be Rayquaza. I mean, Rayquaza would be a pretty good switch in right now, I think, because it can hit Groudon pretty hard.
Yep, but we do see the Hitmontop. Marcus does value that Intimidate.
We do see the Intimidate go off, gonna hit into that Groudon and hit into that Kangaskhan. Kangaskhan now at one stage of decreased attack. Groudon is at two stages of decreased attack. Kangaskhan, of course, is burned, so its physical damage output is gonna be very, very low.
Yeah, Kangaskhan is just about useless right now, so you can pretty much ignore it if you're Marcus. This is a great lock, having one Pokemon just unable to do anything while you just focus down the ally Pokemon.
And we do see Gengar now attack, goes for the Sludge Bomb at the cost of getting hit with the Sucker Punch. Does pick up the KO on this Kangaskhan, even though it wasn't going to do that much damage anyways. As Groudon goes for a huge Precipice Blades right here, it is intimidated twice. Is it going to be enough to pick up the KO? It does pick up the KO on Groudon, and Hitmontop hangs on, only taking about 40%, maybe even 30% right there. And we do see an eject button.
Oh.
So Hitmontop's going to get to switch out for free. Gonna go into his last Pokemon. Of course, Hitmontop can come back in with another Intimidate, as we do see Bronzong come in.
So that's pretty cool. The eject button lets Hitmontop kind of recycle that Intimidate, but
and the fake out.
And the fake out. It's just at this point, it's kind of too late for it to really matter, because I don't think Bronzong and Hitmontop have the damage output to be able to handle Groudon and Xerneas. But that's good knowledge for Eduardo heading into games 2 and 3, knowing that this Hitmontop has eject button. So you can kind of manipulate sometimes when this Hitmontop gets switched out. You can sometimes manipulate it so it gets switched out at inopportune times. For example, if it's in against a Kangaskhan and it's in like a great spot where you want to use close combat on the Kangaskhan, you can maybe force it to switch out with the eject button.
And we do see Groudon switch out back into Eduardo's own Bronzong right here, as Hitmontop does get to go for the fake out, targeting down that Groudon slot that is now the Bronzong. Not very effective with a critical hit, but it doesn't matter too much because Xerneas right now going for a Moonblast onto that Hitmontop, picks up the KO. I mean, it wasn't even close. That was a knockout anyways, as now it's going to be Bronzong versus the rest of Eduardo's team. We do see the Gyro Ball connect onto that Xerneas. Going to see how much damage it does. Does about 40%. A bulky, more slow variant of Xerneas right there.
Yeah, so that's more good knowledge, and we see Marcus sees the writing on the wall, recognizes he can't win this game, so goes out and forfeits. He got the knowledge he needed of how much damage Gyro Ball does to Xerneas, so there wasn't a whole lot of more information to be gained in that situation. It's just it would have made the match take even longer because Xerneas and Bronzong don't do any damage to Bronzong. It would have had to spend turn switching out to Groudon. Marcus just wants to get straight into game two while he's focused. He's in the zone.
Look at that. He looks so calm.
Yeah, he's calm. I think he knows what he wants to do heading into game two. That's probably why he wants to jump right into game two rather than just kind of sit there, continue playing out game one. He just wants to move on and move past that.
Alright, and you know, going back into team preview, we see the Xerneas, Kangaskhan, Groudon, Bronzong, Hitmontop, and Thunders for Eduardo. Marcus, of course, with the Gengar, Rayquaza, Raichu, Bronzong, Hitmontop, and Kyogre. Interesting to note that Marcus opted to not bring his possible Mega in Rayquaza, and also another restricted Pokemon right there as well.
Yeah, since he brought Mega Gengar, he wouldn't have been able to Mega Evolve the Rayquaza, but he still could have brought Rayquaza in that match.
It's still a heavy hitter even without the Mega Evolution.
Yep, right. especially we don't know what item it has, but Life Orb, a very common item, gives it a little extra power. Of course, Focus Sash lets it survive a little longer, especially against the likes of Xerneas, which can knock it out in one hit. So Rayquaza could certainly be something that we see this match. That could be an adjustment Marcus makes to bring more power to his lineup.
And we do see the leads right now for Eduardo. Going to go for the Groudon and Thunderous leads right now, changing it up a little bit as we see Hitmontop and Gengar, the same leads for Marcus. It looks like he has a different game plan right now. As we do see the Intimidate go off, not going to matter too much on that Thunderous, but it is going to affect this Groudon. We're going to have to see how many Intimidates exactly he can get off onto this Groudon with that eject button and being able to rotate those Intimidates.
Yeah, it's just now it's a little riskier because if you bring Kyogre in here, Thunderous just hits it super effectively. So it is riskier bringing Kyogre in this situation. But at the same time, Marcus does have Raichu. Of course, Raichu doesn't fare very well against Groudon at all, but it helps Kyogre with Lightning Rod. It won't be able to take any Thunderbolts from Thunderous or any Thunder Waves thanks to Raichu's ability. And then Kyogre can go ahead and knock out that Groudon. I don't know if Marcus brought Raichu in the back, and it's always risky to switch in Raichu because if Groudon does go for a Precipice Blades, that'll just KO it. So it's risky to switch in Raichu, but if by chance he has it and Kyogre out at the same time, could be a good situation for him.
And we see the Fake Out connect onto that Groudon as Thunderous does get to go for a Taunt right now onto that Gengar. No Protect, no Taunt, no Will-O-Wisp for this Gengar as Gengar goes for a powerful Sludge Bomb onto that Thunder slot, doing about 40% as Groudon flinches and cannot move. No poison from that Sludge Bomb, no residual chip damage right there for that Thunderous.
Yeah, I guess that Taunt was kind of to prevent Gengar from using Protect against Groudon. That way, after this turn, a Fake Out, when he knew his Groudon wasn't going to get a chance to use Precipice Blades anyway, he decided to Taunt Gengar, force it to either switch out or take a Precipice Blades. So I like the Taunt play. Thunder Wave would have, you know, paralyzed Gengar, made it slow, and then if it switches out, kind of reduces its effectiveness later in the game. But he wants the immediate impact of Taunt here, forcing a switch in to be made by Marcus.
And we do see the switch to Kyogre right now. That might be a pretty dangerous switch because Kyogre does not enjoy taking physical attacks from Groudon, barring, well, I don't see a point in going for a
well,
Fire Punch right
now. Well, it was
now.
Bulky. We saw it was pretty bulky. It took that Double Edge pretty well, and the Hitmontop has gotten an Intimidate off. But again, Thunderous can hit it super effectively, so Marcus does have to watch out for that.
And we do see the Wide Guard now from the Hitmontop come out, protecting it from a possible Precipice Blades, as we do see the Thunder Wave onto the... Ooh! The Thunder Wave does paralyze that Kyogre, but we do see a Groudon put up a substitute, so this Groudon right now trying to protect itself from really just anything.
Yeah, that's really good, because if it ever gets down to it, you can always just rotate protects and substitutes until Kyogre gets fully paralyzed, you know, if it ever gets to that point. Of course, for now, you feel safe enough launching an attack, but Hitmontop does have Wide Guard. So maybe you do just want to protect Groudon, but I think you go for a Precipice Blades anyway. Because Thunderous hits Kyogre really hard with a Thunderbolt, it's risky because now Hitmontop is faster than Kyogre, so if it can break Groudon substitute and Kyogre's not fully paralyzed, since the Hitmontop will go first, break the substitute, and then Kyogre get an attack off. That could knock out Groudon, but we're not going to see that.
And we do see Gengar come back in right now, going to go ahead and bring that Shadow Tag ability back out, locking Thunderous and Groudon back in. Yes, that is true. There are no switches right there. Groudon does protect itself, going to try to keep that substitute intact for at least another turn. Thunderous now goes for the Thunderbolt, connecting onto this Kyogre. Going to do about 50% right there, a little bit less than that, 40%, as Kyogre cannot move. It is fully paralyzed, and that is an unfortunate side effect of paralysis.
Yeah, I'm sure Marcus is disappointed because if Kyogre went for, say, a Origin Pulse or an Ice Beam, if Marcus wanted to be more accurate, he could have picked up the KO there on Thunderous. Of course, Groudon protected, so it wouldn't have done anything to Groudon, but he at least would have knocked out this Thunderous, considering Thunderous is super effective against Kyogre and, you know, spreading paralysis throughout Marcus's team. Marcus would have loved to see that attack go off there.
Yeah, and one thing about that substitute is that it's also going to be able to block any more Intimidates from that incoming Hitmontop. So that's a huge substitute right there, you know, looking back a couple turns ago.
And I don't think Gengar will be able to break the substitute either. So Marcus not in great shape here.
Right, and that Sludge Bomb should not be able to pick up the KO on Thunderous. It should survive, as the Sludge Bomb does not pick up the KO. Going to go ahead and activate that Citrus Berry instead. Thunderous is going to go ahead and heal up, as Thunderous now goes for a Thunderbolt onto this Kyogre. and that is gonna be close to pick up the KO as Groudon does go for a Precipice Blaze. As Gengar does avoid the attack though, but the damage is done. Kyra is gonna get knocked out from this Precipice Blaze.
Yeah, I think Eduardo made a great adaptation here, switching to Thundurus as a lead alongside Groudon and leaving them in rather than switching in and out against this Mega Gengar. And I think Eduardo's going to take this. Hitmontop, like you said, since Groudon has a substitute up right now, it can't be intimidated. And Hitmontop not known for its damage. Of course, Gengar Sludge Bomb won't do a whole lot to Groudon. And of course, Precipice Blade, super effective on Gengar, even despite the intimidated. Should, whether it knocks it out this turn, it'll at least knock it out the next turn.
And even then, the Thunders can also threaten with a possible Thunder Wave or even go for a Thunderbolt to pick up the KO, even
right,
if it does survive the Precipice Blades.
Yep.
And Marcus right now really trying to think what his best option is. We're going to have to see if he brought that Bronzong again or he decided to bring Rayquaza, as we do see Hitmontop come in instead, going to go for Intimidate onto that Thunderous. The Groudon, that substitute from three turns ago, paying off so much.
Yeah, and since Kyogre is gone already, that's a big damage dealer. Neither Hitmontop or Gengar are really going to be able to output a whole lot of damage, so I sure hope for Marcus' sake Rayquaza's in the back rather than Bronzong, otherwise Eduardo might have this game wrapped up already.
And we do see the fake out onto that Thunderous, going to go ahead and pick up the KO with the Sludge Bomb. Just a little bit of protection just in case Thunderous decide to go for a Thunder Wave or a Taunt. We do see the Precipice Blades right now connect onto both Gengar and Hitmontop. Picks up the KO on Gengar easily, and now it's going to be Hitmontop. Well, it's a critical hit, but I'm pretty sure that was still a KO.
It was intimidated, and Marcus may have trained his Gengar to be a little bulkier to take a Precipice Blades.
After the intimidate.
Right, but at the same time, I don't know if that would have mattered. And if Bronzong's in the back anyway, so I definitely don't think that would have mattered because there's just no way for Marcus to handle this Groudon behind the substitute with the likes of a Hitmontop, a Gengar, and a Bronzong.
Yeah, and, you know, it's one of those things, you know, Gengar really has only a couple options for attacking. Shadow Ball, Sludge Bomb, maybe a Hidden Power Water. We do see Xerneas come in, gonna go ahead and exert that Fairy Aura, but it's not going to matter too much because there's just not enough offensive presence out on Marcus' side. But going back to what I was saying, you know, the Gengar, if it had Shadow Ball, it might have been able to do something. That would have easily been able to break that substitute, but instead we see Marcus forfeit because there's just no offense.
Yeah.